We want to identify the greatest common factor of each binomial and then factor each binomial. The greatest common factor is the largest monomial that would divide evenly into each term. So looking at our first example, we have 4x to the third plus 12x. Notice the greatest common factor of 4 and 12 would be 4, and the greatest common factor of x to the third and x would be x. Therefore, the greatest common factor of this binomial is 4x. Another way to see this would be to write 4x cubed as 2 times 2 times x times x times x. Notice that 2 times 2 is the prime factorization of 4, and then we expanded the variable factors. Plus, 12 can be written as 4 times 3, but we can write 4 as 2 times 2, so the prime factorization of 12 would be 2 times 2 times 3 times a factor of x. When it's written in this form, we can easily see that both terms have two factors of 2 in common, as well as one factor of x. Notice how the highlighted factors represent the GCF, which would be 4x. And when it's written in this form, it makes it very easy to factor. If we factor out 4x, the factors that are not highlighted would remain. So if we factor out 4x from 4x cubed, we're left with x squared. When we factor 4x out of 12x, we're left with 3. So here we have the binomial in factored form, and our GCF is 4x. So if you're able to look at these two terms and identify the greatest common factor of 4x, that's great. But if you're not sure, you can always write the coefficients in prime factored form and expand the variable factors. So now looking at our second example, the greatest common factor is going to consist of the greatest common factor of 18 and 45, as well as the greatest common factor of a to the fourth, b to the third, and a to the second, b to the fifth. Let's go ahead and expand this. We're going to write 18 as 2 times 9. 9 is 3 times 3. So for the first term, we'd have 2 times 3 times 3. Then we have 4 factors of a and 3 factors of b. Plus for 45, well, that'd be 9 times 5, and 9 is 3 times 3. So we have 2 factors of 3, 1 factor of 5, and then for a to the second, b to the fifth, we'd have 2 factors of a, and then 5 factors of b. And now we can highlight all the factors they have in common. Notice they both have 2 factors of 3, 2 factors of a, and 3 factors of b in common. So the greatest common factor is going to be 9, a to the second, b to the third. And then one thing to notice about the variable factors of the greatest common factor, they'll always be the lowest exponent on the common base. Notice how we have a to the fourth, a to the second. A to the second is part of the GCF. And we have b to the third, b to the fifth, and b to the third is part of the GCF. So now we're going to go ahead and factor out 9, a to the second, b to the third, and we're going to be left with all the factors that are not highlighted. So if we factor out 9, a to the second, b to the third from the first term, we're going to be left with 2, a to the second, plus if we factor out 9, a to the second, b to the third from the second term, we're left with 5, b to the second. Again, here's our GCF, and here's the binomial in factored form. We'll take a look at two more examples in the next video.